is your Catholic Daily Journal for Saturday, February the 2nd, 2019. Today is Candlemas, the traditional day for the blessing of candles in the church, and one of the traditional ends of the Christmas season, depending on what country you come from. It's the feast of the presentation of our Lord in the temple, and the feast of the purification of the Blessed Virgin Mary, which are actually one and the same event. Jesus was born on Christmas in Bethlehem. They didn't go home, though. Instead, they camped out there for a week, and they took him to be circumcised on the eighth day, and that's when Jesus gets his name there in the local community. Then the family heads home to Nazareth, but about a month later, they load up the camel again and head to Jerusalem. The law says that on the 40th day after birth, a male child is to be presented in the temple, and the mother is to bring a purification offering. This is when they encounter the old man Simeon and the holy woman Anna. We should say that the feast of the purification of the Blessed Virgin Mary is old. We have records of it being celebrated in the 320s AD. It was renamed after Vatican II. Why? No reason, just cause. The tradition of blessing candles comes from the ongoing theme of God's revealing himself in his son Jesus as the light of the world, first at Christmas, then at Epiphany, and then in the temple on this day. Today is also Bloomsday in Ireland, the annual celebration of the publication of Ulysses by James Joyce, so named for one of the main protagonists of his book, Leopold Bloom. The novel is named after Odysseus from Homer's epic poem, The Odyssey. Joyce's novel is not an easy read, but it's a massive influence upon many modern Irish authors through its use of stream of consciousness and its very free use of puns and parodies. No less than John Updike, Samuel Beckett, and Joseph Campbell consider the novel a masterpiece. The tradition in Ireland today is to follow the schedule of Leopold Bloom through the day by eating what he ate, visiting the sites he visited, and drinking. Lots of drinking. It's Dublin, after all. Bloomsday is also celebrated with myriad tours, book studies, and semi-formal lectures in pubs all across the Temple Bar and Bachelor's Walk regions of Dublin. Today in the U.S., it's Groundhog Day, the traditional day in which large rodents become briefly adorable when they pop out of the holes wherever they darn well and whenever they darn well please. And if they do so early enough in the day to see their shadows, then winter is or is not going to end earlier or later. There's actual real science behind the times at which various types of animals emerge from their nests, cocoons, ground holes, etc., based on ground temperature, air temperature, humidity, the ultraviolet quantity of ratings, and things like that. But for the most of the United States, it's just kind of a fun callback to the days of the Farmer's Almanac and an excuse to watch one of the greatest comedy films of all time. I don't recommend reading the story by Danny Rubin that inspired Harold Ramis in the screenplay of the 1993 classic starring Bill Murray. In the short story, Murray's character Phil is in the loop for 10,000 years and is quite insane when he finally graduates to February 3rd. Better just to stick with the movie. Finally, today is the birthday of Miss Eva Cassidy. She was born in 1963 in Washington, D.C., and spent most of her life singing backup vocals and experimenting with basically every genre of music she could get her hands on. She never hit it big because she never settled on a single style. She died in 1996 of cancer, and that was, strangely enough, when one of her tracks was played by Terry Wogan on BBC Radio 2, and that's when she hit it big. Her albums were suddenly in demand for her remarkable subtlety and the grace of her voice. Fields of Gold, Somewhere Over the Rainbow, these are her most popular tracks. She died young and never knew success, but she was a remarkable singer, one of my favorites, and today is her birthday. The Catholic Daily Journal is supported by listeners like you. For more information, visit CatholicUnderground.com. Until next time, be on the lookout for the Lord at work in your life.